of geography of Europe. Europe is going to be the primary location for this medieval period, for the Middle Ages that we're going to be discussing over the next couple of weeks. So I kind of want to introduce you to what the geography looks like and kind of how that influences what's going on. So the first little bit, the Middle Ages in Europe is going to take place in Europe. For this reason, there's going to be lots of different little independent kingdoms that develop throughout Europe. And a lot of those are influenced by how the geography of Europe looks. So those are both directly correlated to each other. Next big thing you kind of need to know about Europe is that it is a peninsula. Okay, the entire continent of Europe as a whole is a peninsula itself. It's surrounded by water. But a part of what makes Europe so unique with a part of the peninsulas is that each little piece of Europe kind of has its own unique feature, but there are lots of smaller peninsulas that kind of break away from Europe itself. So you have the Iberian Peninsula, you have the Italian Peninsula, you have the Greek Peninsula. There's a bunch of little ones that kind of pop up as well. Because it is surrounded by water, two of the big bodies of water that you're going to see here for Europe, you're going to have the Atlantic Ocean off to the west, and then you're going to have the Mediterranean Sea to the south. Now, there's lots of different rivers and seas and smaller things throughout the continent, but these are going to be your two big bodies of water. And because they are going to be surrounded by water, this is going to make Europe a very, very, very important part of the trade that pops up when we see this modern world. Now, some of the major rivers and seas, you're going to have the Rhine and the Danube, a couple of others. But one of the things that the rivers and seas get is that they are going to be wide enough and deep enough throughout Europe for ships and boats to travel up. And it's going to allow the people in Europe to be able to trade with those coming in. The other part about those is that it's also going to protect from invasions. You're not going to be able to have a whole naval crew coming up in against the rivers and things like that into your country. These rivers are also going to separate people. Anytime you start having geographical features and it's something that people don't travel over all the time, it's always going to separate. So what you're going to see is these small independent kingdoms that develop in Europe throughout the Middle Ages are going to be doing so in part because of the rivers and seas that separate them. And the cultures that are going to develop because of that are going to be very, very different from each other. They're going to be very distinguished. Now, with your rivers and seas, you also have lots of different mountain ranges in Europe as well. You have the Pyrenees, you have the Alps, the Carpathians, the Urals. All of these different mountain ranges are going to do the same thing that your rivers do. It's going to provide them with protection, but it's also going to isolate them and separate them from the other people groups in Europe. So one of the things that you see with these mountains is that, yes, it separates and isolates them. Yes, it allows these independent kingdoms to form. Yes, it allows them to kind of develop their own cultures so that they're different and distinguished. But the other piece is that it's really hard to conquer mountains and people surrounding the mountains. So one of the things that your mountains are going to do is it's going to prevent one group of people in Europe from controlling the whole thing. It's where it separates them out. This kind of separation is going to be, hey, we're separated, but you can't come in and conquer me easily because we have mountains that separate us. And so these mountains are going to allow them to form and prevent, it's going to allow them to form these independent kingdoms and kind of these specific cultures, but it's also going to prevent them from one person controlling all of Europe. So we've talked, we've introduced the Middle Ages, we've talked to you about the geography. If you have any other questions or concerns, anything like that about the video, feel free to email me.